Hi and welcome to this video on waves. So in this video we'll be looking at two things. We'll be looking at the main features of waves and the wave equation. So the first type of wave we're going to look at is called a transverse wave. Now transverse waves have a very distinct pattern, and the pattern you're looking for is that it goes up and down. Okay? Now it seems quite obvious, most waves that you would probably have seen in the past, such as waves on water, would have this particular pattern. Okay, but there is another type of wave which we'll look at in a minute or two. Now, with transverse waves, there are certain things we need to be aware of. The first thing we need to be aware of, okay, is that the wave is going to travel across in this direction. But at the same time, the wave itself goes up and down. So the direction of the wave is at 90 degrees, because if we were to draw a little box here, that would be 90 degrees, okay, to the disturbance of the wave. Now the easiest way of remembering this is if you're at sea and you're on a small boat, and let's say the boat was here, then the boat would go up and down even though the wave is going in this direction. And the relationship between you going up and down and the wave going across is 90 degrees. We also need to be aware of some other key features of a transverse wave. We have what are referred to as crests or peaks and troughs. Now, the crest or the peak and the troughs are the maximum distance, okay, from the equilibrium, which is this line in the middle, okay, sometimes referred to as a zero line, okay, especially on an oscilloscope. So the crest is the highest point, the trough is the lowest point. But the distance between the equilibrium and the crest and the distance between the equilibrium and the trough will be the same. There will be the same distance. And we call this distance between the equilibrium and the crest, okay, or the trough, the amplitude. Okay, so the amplitude, or the easiest way of remembering what amplitude is that it's the height of the wave. So the amplitude is the height of the wave. We can also see here that we have the wavelength, okay, labelled up. Now the wavelength is the length of the wave from one position to exactly the same position on the next wave. So from here to here is one wavelength. Now we could also measure it from peak to peak or from trough to trough, because those are the same positions. And in an exam, I would suggest, okay, you always measure it from peak to peak, or as we're calling them here, crests. The only other thing we need to be aware of, okay, is something called frequency. Now, frequency is how many times something occurs within a period of time itself. So, frequency with the wave is measured in hertz. And hertz is a unit which represents the amount of waves in a second. So, if this time scale here, this dotted line all the way across here, okay, was 1 second, then we would have 1, 2 waves. So 2 waves in 1 second would be the same as saying we had 2 hertz. If you had 60 waves in a second, that would be 60 hertz. 120 waves in a second, 120 hertz. So frequency is waves in a second. Our second type of wave, which is represented by this diagram, okay, is called a longitudinal wave. Now, longitudinal waves are very different from a transverse wave in that we don't have the usual up and down features of a transverse wave. Instead, we just have one long wave that has compressions and rarefactions. Now, compression is when the particles which the wave is causing to move causes the wave to come close together. Rarefaction is where it expands. So compression, okay, is where the particles are close together. A rarefaction, okay, is where the particles are moving apart. Now, an example of where you would find this, okay, is a sound wave. You're listening to me right now. And that means, okay, that the particles coming from, or sorry, the sound coming from the speakers is causing the particles in the air, okay, to be compressed, okay, and the rarefactions as it moves through the air towards your eardrum, where it's making your eardrum vibrate and able to hear me. So now that we understand, okay, about transverse waves and longitudinal waves, we can start to look at something called the wave equation. Now the wave equation takes in three pieces of information. Okay, the wave speed, frequency, and wavelength. Now, to be able to calculate the wave speed, we multiply the frequency by the wavelength. However, it is possible to work out the wave speed if we have both of these two types of information, and it's possible to work out the wavelength if we have the wave speed and the frequency. Now, wave speed is measured in meters per second, frequency, as we said before, is measured in hertz, and wavelength has to be measured in meters. Okay, and it's important that you remember it's in meters in case there are any questions on your exam in centimeters where you would need to convert these. Now, as usual, okay, I've put together a formula triangle for you. Okay, so this time, okay, we can see we have different letters representing various parts of the wave speed or wave equation formula. So, wave speed over here, okay, is represented by the V. Frequency is represented by the F. Okay, and wavelength, okay, is this symbol here, which we refer to as being called lambda. So to be able to calculate wave speed, we cover up the V, and that tells us it's frequency times wavelength. To calculate frequency, we cover up the F, and that tells us it's wave speed divided by wavelength. And finally, to calculate wavelength, we cover up lambda, and that tells us, okay, it's wave speed divided by frequency. So let's have a go applying the wave equation formula. So the question is, a trumpet produces a note of 75 centimeters in length. The speed of sound is 330 meters per second, so what is the frequency of the note? So as usual, okay, I'm going to suggest you maybe look at the question, pause the video, have a go at it yourself, and then come back and look at the worked example. Okay. So, the first thing we need to think about here, okay, is actually what the question's asking us to work out. So it says the speed of sound is 330 meters per second. What is the frequency? So we're not being asked to calculate the wave speed here. We're actually being asked to calculate the frequency. So, as before, we cover up the F, and that tells us that the formula for frequency is wave speed divided by wavelength. So let's have a go at this. So we know that the frequency, which is F, is the wave speed divided by wavelength. And we know that the wave speed in this question is 330. Now, the wavelength in the question says 75 centimetres. However, wavelength is measured in metres. So to be able to turn centimetres into metres, okay, we need to obviously divide by 100. So that would give us 0.75. So it'd be 330 divided by 0.75. And if we do that, we should find, okay, that our frequency is 440. Now we said that frequency earlier is measured in hertz, so that would be 440 hertz, which is the same as 440 waves every second. Now hopefully this video has been of some use to you. If it has, feel free to subscribe. There'll be more coming along shortly. And good luck revising.